So comes, why should you watch the webinar today? I hope that you save some time after you see what to-do can do for you. Certainly, we keep a lot of to-do lists either on our phone, on our PC, even on little yellow sticky notes. It's very easy to lose tasks when you keep so many different to-do lists around, so I'm hoping you save some time. Also, I want you to get more value from your Office 365 subscription. We're paying a dollar amount per user per month, and we want to get the most value for those subscriptions. So, Microsoft To Do, as I mentioned, it's available in a variety of different places: web, mobile, Android, iOS. It's available on your tablet, and there's a Windows 10 desktop app as well. We'll go through all of those. I can show you some of the nuances. So, what is Microsoft To Do? If you're someone like me, I'm a big personal productivity nut. I love David Allen's book, Getting Things Done. I love to keep all of my to-dos and tasks and future tasks all in one central place, in one trusted system. And that's certainly what Microsoft To Do can help you accomplish. It's available everywhere, web, mobile, and desktop, so you don't have to worry about leaving things behind or not having access to your to-do list. It's powered by some very interesting Office 365 integrations, which we're going to cover later. It's meant to be collaborative, so you can share to-do lists with teammates. You can even use Microsoft To Do on the personal side of life, so grocery lists or task lists around the house you can share. And it's meant to help you focus, so we'll demonstrate the My Day and how you can categorize different to-do items to keep you focused. What to do is not? To do is not really a great solution for micromanagers or those that like to break big projects into little tasks and assign them out and keep time accounting and those types of procedures. To do is quite simple. It's meant to be lightweight and in and out. It is not meant as a project management replacement. So if you are used to using Microsoft Project or similar solutions, to do, again, not really a great fit for that kind of work. And although you can add deadlines and time reminders to items in To Do, and you can add files and attachments to to-do tasks, Microsoft To Do is not really a great calendar or OneNote replacement. So we're going to jump right into a demonstration, and let's take a look at how To Do can save you some time. Now we're in our browser. The easiest way to launch Microsoft To Do is from the Office 365 portal. You can get there by going to office.com and logging in with your Office 365 credentials. You'll see all of your apps icons here that are available to you as part of your Office 365 subscription, and To Do should be among that list. Here's the blue icon. This sort of looks like a check mark for To Do. We'll go ahead and click and launch a new tab with Microsoft To Do. And what we're prompted with here first is actually our master task list. Now, this is going to be everything that we add to the to-do system is going to be compiled here in tasks. So I've gone ahead and pre-populated six tasks just for today's webinar. Let's go ahead and add a few more just so you can see how easy it is to add tasks to this interface. And we'll click over here on Add a Task. We'll click in with our cursor. You can see that begins to blink. And we can use keyboard to add a few tasks. You can use the mouse to click to the next line to add a new task, or you can simply press enter and move on and add tasks sort of in a rapid fire mode. So let's add a few more here. So here, a few tasks really quickly, very easy to get tasks into a trusted system. We're not adding a lot of information, we can do that later, but at least we're getting these into our to-do system. Let's say though that we do want to add some more context to this particular task, review competitors' websites. By clicking on the to-do item, you're going to open this action panel here on the right of the browser, and we can see we have a number of different options. We have the ability to add steps. We have the ability to add this task to the My Day view. We'll focus on that in a few minutes. We have the ability to add a reminder, a due date, potentially repeat this task, add files, and add notes. Further on down here, we can also delete the task as well if we made an error. In this example, we want to review our competitors' websites. Let's say we want to do this monthly. We can click the repeat button, select the monthly frequency, and the system's going to remind us sort of on a monthly basis that we need to review our competitors' websites. Another way to get to this interesting context menu for any task item, you can also right-click on any of these items and have the ability again, add to my day, mark as complete, mark as important, maybe set a due date for today, tomorrow, create a new list from this task. I'll show you that in a moment. You can move the task to certain lists that we're going to create. You can copy the task or you can delete it from here as well. Let's take a look at planned marketing materials now, and let's go ahead and add this to my day. I'll click that button and let's flip over to the My Day list. My Day is a great way to add context to, again, that master list of to-do tasks that you have. It helps you focus on the few things that you want to get done today or within the next few hours. If you read David Allen's book, having context to your to-do items certainly helps take some of the anxiety away of having a very, very large to-do list. From the My Day view, a couple of other items that are really cool. At the top right here, there's the suggestions button. And then this is using AI and sort of system generated intelligence to help you pick items that you can add for your day upcoming. So maybe you're sitting down first thing in the morning with a hot cup of coffee and you want to build up the items of tasks, list of tasks that you want to get done today. We can perhaps get copier toner done today, and we know we have time to review payroll. So we'll add those to My Day. Jumping back to the view, you can see now that we have three things to get done today. Let's go ahead now and add some sub-steps to one of the to-do tasks we have in the My Day view. Let's pick on plan marketing materials, and we'll move our cursor over here to the blue Add Step link. Clicking that opens up a text field, and we could use a keyboard to import our sub-steps. So there we have two sub-steps to print everything and bring markers to do some markup of our marketing materials. Very easy to delete steps if you make a mistake or you want to shorten down the task. Just by clicking on the X icon here, you can remove and delete those steps. Jumping back to My Day, let's go ahead and actually make a whole new list. There's a link over here on the left-hand column to add a new list. You can move your cursor there and click, and let's name this new list marketing and press enter. We see that it's already brought us up a new list, no tasks in it yet, and we do have the ability to do some different options here. We can rename the list, we can actually change the theme, so if you want to color code some of your sub lists so that they stand out a little bit more visually, let's change marketing to green, and now we can actually add more tasks here quickly, or we can go back to My Day, and since planned marketing materials should probably also fit in the marketing category, we can move this task to the marketing list, and there we have it. Let's add another new list here for purchases. Maybe we change the theme of this one to purple. We go back to our all task list, and things that we need to buy should probably be on that purchasing list to help us add some context. So purchase toner can go there, and maybe pick up Mary's car can go there as well. As I mentioned in my introduction to Microsoft To-Do, there's some interesting collaboration features here built in as well, because this is part of Office 365. Let's jump over now to our marketing list. I'm actually going to right click on the list name and click share list. This allows you to send an invitation link to anyone in your Office 365 organization. So anyone in your company, you can actually both see this list and both add and remove items at the same time. Really handy if you have a small team or a couple of people that are involved in the same projects, marketing, purchasing, for example. Okay, let's close out of the sharing box here. One interesting tweak you can make to the user interface here, especially with sublists, is reordering them on this left panel. For example, if you want purchases to appear above marketing, not a problem to just click, drag, and drop and move those around as you see fit. Let's jump back to My Day. And we spent a lot of time talking about planning marketing materials. I feel confident that we can check this off as complete. And let's jump into the review payroll. In this one, I'd like to add a due date of tomorrow. I also want to add a note. Again, fairly easy to use mouse and keyboard to navigate around the web interface and add information as we need. One last thing I want to show you on the web interface is actually another integration using Office 365. Let's jump back to our O365 portal and open up Outlook Webmail. And I'm going to drop down to the bottom here on the left into our Tasks view. That's going to open another tab, and this is going to show you Office 365 Tasks. And we can see here that the categories that we've made in To-Do, Marketing and Purchasing, show up here. And so do all of our tasks that we create in Microsoft To-Do. So a really interesting integration point here between Outlook tasks and Microsoft To-Do. Anything you make in one place or the other, any of the categories or sublists that you make in one or the other will appear back into the other application. This is also true for Outlook on your desktop. Here, just for the purposes of the demo, I'm just showing the Outlook web app. Microsoft has also made an excellent Windows 10 application for Microsoft To-Do. So if you prefer to download an application and use it normally on your desktop, on your PC, not a problem. You do have that flexibility with Microsoft To-Do. So here I've gone ahead and launched the app. A lot of similarities between the actual desktop application and the web app. The interface here is a little bit more colorful. The icons are a little bit different, but you'll see that all of our tasks, lists, all of our color coding that we did, all of the tasks that we added on the web app have synchronized here with the desktop application really well. Let's jump back to my day. We still have the suggestions tool. We still have the ability to change themes, add tasks. Again, just about everything that we can do on the web interface, we can do here on the desktop application as well. A couple of neat things that are unique to the desktop application. Let me just open my start menu here. And you can see that Windows 10 actually has a live tile for the To-Do application. So if you don't have the app open or you're in your start menu quite frequently, you can see a live tile of your day or any of the other sub-lists that you make in Microsoft To-Do. As well, Microsoft has developed Cortana integration. So if you do use the Cortana feature of your desktop notebook with Windows 10, you can add tasks to your To-Do list through Microsoft Cortana. So everything I've shown you so far is really great if you're in front of your desktop PC or you've got your notebook on the go. But what if you're really mobile and you only have access to your phone, or perhaps you're relaxing at home one evening and you do want to add something to your work to-do list for the next day? Microsoft has published both Android and iOS apps for Microsoft To-Do. They all look very similar, all the same interface, and very similar to what we've seen on the Windows 10 app as well as the desktop app. So very familiar, not a lot of a learning curve here to use this product on the go. Let's run through a quick scenario now of something that we might do with Microsoft To-Do on our phones. Let's say, for example, we're out shopping and we see a phone case that we want to buy for all of our colleagues' phones in the office. In the app here, let's switch over to our purchases list. You can see again, any of the themes, any of the color coding, any of the tagging that we've created in any of the other apps is going to show here on the mobile app. I'm going to click the plus icon in the lower right of the app, and we're going to add a new task here. We're going to be purchasing phone cases. And by clicking the blue up arrow here, we're adding that to the purchases list. Now, let's click on to that item, bring up the context menu to add some more information here. And again, because we're out in the go, and in this example, we're at a retail store, we can actually add a file. We can take a picture from our photo gallery or using the camera on our smartphones. In this case, I'm just going to use one from my gallery of a blue phone case that I fell in love with at a retail store. Now let's select the hamburger menu here in the top left and jump back to my day. Let's say it's the end of the day and we are able to knock a few more of these tasks off of our to-do list. Quite a rewarding feeling. And again, any of the tasks that you select as completed in any of these apps are all going to synchronize together in one central place. All right, so that's all I had on my to-do list for today's webinar to show you and demonstrate Microsoft To-Do. Again, let's have a quick recap before we sign off on Webinar Wednesday. Microsoft To-Do is another tool in your productivity kit, one central place on all of your different devices, web, desktop, and mobile, to synchronize tasks and add items on the go. It does sync with Outlook tasks, so if you are familiar with using Outlook web app or the Outlook on your desktop, Rest assured that you can bring Microsoft To Do into your productivity workflow and not miss a beat. There's some intelligence in Microsoft To Do, so if you are sitting down in the morning and want to build out your to-do list, three or four things to focus on for the day, the system's certainly going to do its best to help recommend tasks that you need to work on. And I'm hoping that you're sharing and collaborating on to-do lists, as that collaboration really is a central point of Office 365.